Hello everyone! Today I will tell you about 6 little known and little studied vitamins, about vitamins which are very important for energy production, for healthy blood vessels and also for beautiful skin and hair, and even about a vitamin that is not available in supplements. Let's go! Para-aminobenzoic acid, also known as 4-aminobenzoic acid or PABA, I will call it PABA, is sometimes called vitamin BX or vitamin B10, but it's not a true vitamin. PABA is a natural substance, a component in the molecule of folic and folinic acids, which is involved in the synthesis of folic acid. PABA has an antithyroxic effect and therefore it is used in the treatment of thyrotoxicosis. Thyrotoxicosis is a clinical state that results from inappropriately high thyroid hormone action in tissues, generally due to inappropriately high tissue thyroid hormone levels. PABA is involved in processes that provide pigmentation in hair and skin. Under the influence of ultraviolet rays, PABA undergoes photochemical transformations, which lead to the synthesis of substances that stimulate the formation of pigment melanin, which gives the skin a dark tan color. PABA has the following effects on the skin. Blocks ultraviolet radiation on the skin, therefore it is used as a sunscreen. Reduces burn pain. Keeps skin healthy and smooth. And now attention! Helps to slow down the formation of wrinkles. With its deficiency, early graying of hair and eczema develops. PABA promotes the absorption and therefore the effectiveness of pantothenic acid. In experiments on animals, it was shown that in combination with pantothenic acid, it helps restore the previous color of gray hair. For some people, combining folic acid with para-aminobenzoic acid has restored graying hair to its natural color. Sources of PABA include liver, Brewer's yeast, kidney, brown grains, rice, bran, sprouted wheat, and molasses. The need for PABA is partially covered by endogenous synthesis of the intestinal microflora. In supplements, it is available in doses of 30 to 1000 mg in regular and prolonged form. Toxic effects are not known, but long-term use of large doses is not recommended. Symptoms that may indicate a para-aminobenzoic overdose are usually nausea and vomiting. Vitamin B13 orotic acid is a poorly studied vitamin involved in the metabolism of folic acid and vitamin B12. According to some reports, it may interfere with the aging process. The effect of vitamin B13 is as follows. It has a beneficial effect on the reproductive system, on the functional state of the liver. It accelerates the regeneration of liver cells and has a stimulating effect on protein metabolism. Orotic acid is involved in the metabolism of folic acid, the synthesis of methionine, and the conversion of pantothenic acid. Orotic acid is synthesized in sufficient quantities in humans and animals. Cases of vitamin B13 deficiency have not been described. However, signs of vitamin B13 deficiency can be various liver diseases. Orotic acid is found in plant roots and in the liquid part of curdled milk or whey, in kumis, in liver and yeast. In supplements, orotic acid is usually in the form of orotate, in doses of 500 to 740 mg. Vitamin P are plant polyphenols, which are a group of biologically active substances: rutin, hesperidin, catechins, quercetin, citrin, citrus bioflavonoids, etc. Flavonoids are substances that give citrus fruits their orange and yellow color. These substances interact with vitamin C, reduce capillary permeability, and increase capillary strength. That is why they are named vitamin P, from the English word permeability. Vitamin P is essential for the proper action and absorption of vitamin C. It protects vitamin C from oxidative degradation, promotes the accumulation of vitamin C in tissues, increases its effectiveness, and also helps vitamin C to maintain healthy connective tissue. It strengthens the capillary walls, thus preventing bruising. It also helps increase resistance to infections and helps prevent and treat bleeding gums. Vitamin P stimulates tissue respiration and affects the activity of the endocrine glands. It helps in the treatment of vertigo caused by diseases of the inner ear. In clinical practice, vitamin P is used for hemorrhagic diathesis, gastric and duodenal ulcers, hypertension, atherosclerosis, rheumatism, varicose veins, and other pathological conditions. Vitamin P is found in the white peel and intralobular part of citrus fruits, lemons, oranges, and grapefruits, as well as in apricots, buckwheat, blackberries, cherries, and rose hips. Usually, vitamin P is used as part of the C complex or separately. The most common doses of rutin and hesperidin are 100 mg 3 times a day. All vitamin C supplements work best with bioflavonoids. Daily intakes haven't been set, but most nutritionists recommend taking at least 100 mg of bioflavonoids for every 500 mg of vitamin C. The toxicity of vitamin P has not been established. Vitamin P deficiency leads to fragility and impaired permeability of small vessels, capillaries, at the same time pain in the legs when walking, in the shoulders, general weakness, lethargy, and fatigue are noted. Small skin hemorrhages, petechia, appear in the form of small punctate rashes in the area of hair follicles, especially often in places subject to the pressure of tight clothing, as well as in the case of injuries to the body. Deficiency of vitamin P occurs with a prolonged deficiency in the diet of fresh vegetables, fruits, and berries, especially in the winter-spring period. Its nutritional deficiency usually accompanies vitamin C deficiency. Tips from Dr. Earl Mindel. Menopausal women experience some relief during hot flashes when they increase their intake of bioflavonoids in combination with vitamin C. Anyone with a bruising tendency will benefit from taking vitamin C supplements with bioflavonoids, rutin, and hesperidin. I recommend adding such a complex in the prevention and treatment of chronic venous insufficiency and varicose veins of the legs, and also in the treatment of pelvic venous disorders such as hemorrhoids or piles, varicose uterine veins, and varicose testicular veins or varicocele. Vitamin B11 or carnitine is a natural vitamin-like substance that is widely found in everyday foods. Carnitine is one of the specific constituents of muscles. It is found in muscles in an amount of 20 to 50%. With a lack of carnitine, the normal functioning of muscle tissue is disrupted. Its deficiency in food leads to a decrease in energy metabolism in cells, the accumulation of fat in the body, and the progressive development of muscle weakness. The inclusion of carnitine in the diet stimulates the oxidation of fatty acids in the mitochondria of the muscles and thus helps to reduce the accumulation of fat in the tissues. Therefore, if you want to reduce the amount of fatty tissue and to increase muscle strength, you should pay attention to carnitine. Most of the carnitine in the human body is synthesized from essential amino acids, lysine and methionine, a non-essential amino acid, glutamic acid, as well as from free vitamins, vitamin C, niacin, and vitamin B6, and iron as well. The final stages of carnitine formation take place in the liver, kidneys, and brain. Carnitine can be used in the complex therapy of diseases in which the use of anabolic agents is indicated. It causes an improvement in appetite, acceleration of growth, an increase in body weight, and helps to normalize the basal metabolism in hypothyroidism. It is used for angina pectoris, for the prevention and additional therapy of atherosclerosis, and it also helps to reduce the level of cholesterol and triglycerides in the blood. Carnitine is used for anorexia, malnutrition, and growth retardation in children. Adults are prescribed carnitine as an anabolic agent for anorexia due to nervous exhaustion after illness, operations, and chronic coronary artery disease. Vitamin Q, ubiquinone, coenzyme Q10, or simply Q, is a lipophilic molecule which consists of a group of quinones and a polyisoprenoid tail, which in humans has 10 units, CoQ10. It is found in cell membranes, especially in large amounts in mitochondria. Mitochondria are cell organelles that generate most of the chemical energy needed to power the cell's biochemical reactions. In other words, mitochondria is the powerhouse of the cell. The biochemical pathway responsible for CoQ biosynthesis includes a large number of complex reactions, such as phosphorylation, methylation, decarboxylation, hydroxylation, and deamination reactions. So why does the body need to use so many complex processes to get coenzyme Q? And the answer is, CoQ is essential for oxidative metabolism or cell respiration. It is a chemical process in which oxygen is used to make energy from carbohydrates, sugars. Every cell in our body needs energy to grow, to divide, and to maintain life. And indeed, CoQ is found throughout the body in all systems of organs. The highest concentration of ubiquinone is observed in the tissues of the heart, kidneys, liver, and muscles. Coenzyme Q is also very important as an endogenous antioxidant. It destroys free radicals, molecules that can damage our cells and tissues. CoQ is used primarily for the treatment of cardiovascular diseases. Coenzyme Q10 is involved in the synthesis of adenosine triphosphate, ATP, and is therefore useful in preventing cellular damage during ischemia reperfusion injury. Several studies showed that coenzyme Q could be useful in patients with congestive heart failure, angina pectoris, cardiomyopathy, coronary artery disease, and in the preservation of myocardium. In cancer patients, it may protect the heart from the cardiotoxic side effects of chemotherapy drugs. Due to its immunostimulating effect, Q can be used as an adjunctive therapy in immunocompromised people. Normal blood levels of the vitamin Q are between 0.30 and 3.84 micrograms per milliliter, although these numbers can vary significantly from person to person. Scientists became interested in studying the vitamin after identifying its deficiency in many patients. Patients with CoQ deficiency can be classified into two groups. People with primary deficiency have mutations in one of the genes involved in CoQ10 biosynthesis. In secondary deficiency, there are mutations in genes not associated with CoQ10 biosynthesis pathway or non-genetic causes. Patients with CoQ deficiency may have neuromuscular disorders such as encephalopathy, damage or disease that affects the brain. Cerebellar ataxia, a degenerative disease of the nervous system with an inability to coordinate balance, gait, extremity and eye movements, muscle weakness, generalized weakness, hypotonia, psychomotor delay, seizures, stroke-like episodes, and cerebellar and cerebral atrophy. Deficiency of this vitamin can also lead to retinitis pigmentosa, optic nerve atrophy, bilateral sensory neural deafness, nephrotic syndrome, and cardiomyopathy. Patients with all forms of vitamin Q deficiency have shown clinical improvement with oral CoQ10 supplementation. In supplements, CoQ10 is usually available in the dosage of 100 to 400 mg per day. CoQ10 deficiency can be caused by oxidative stress due to vitamin E deficiency. Therefore, make sure you are getting sufficient intake of this vitamin as well. Little is known about vitamin T except that it promotes blood clotting and the formation of platelets, blood cells involved in blood clotting. Due to these properties, it is very important in the prevention of some forms of anemia and hemophilia. RDAs have not been established and there are no supplements on sale. It was found in sesame seeds and egg yolks. The toxicity of vitamin T is not known. There was a lot of information for today, and with this saturated video, I end the series about vitamins. Of course, I will be coming back to them over and over again in the context of the treatment of various diseases. So, if you are prescribed any vitamin, you can always watch a full review on this vitamin on my channel. Therefore, subscribe to my channel so as not to lose me in a huge informational floor. I will continue to cover important medical topics. Thank you guys so much for watching. Take care of your body and mind. Bye.